Good afternoon, good morning, good evening. This is DSP News, your number one source for unreliable, late, never breaking news on DSP and his shenanigans. Ladies and gentlemen, we broke a report to you only a few days ago talking about the shenanigans that Brightside Viking apparently got himself into. And he even felt the need to actually contact us directly, saying that we had the story wrong, so on and so forth. Interestingly enough, when our second report, the follow-up, came out, we didn't hear anything. It happens, ladies and gentlemen, it happens. But a contributor to the channel, a friend of ours, Doom, has been keeping us up to date on the situation. And interestingly enough, and for some of you guys who may not know, about 2 days ago, Phil went into full damage control. 2 days from the time that I am recording this video, which this is currently being recorded on the 16th, Phil went into full damage control about 2 days ago, trying to do the best that he can, having his mods throw the ban hammer on anybody who dared to mention the situation, who dared to mention anything about a dox, death threats, so on and so forth. We all know how Phil gets down when it comes to this stuff. Now, with that being said, and as I had said in our previous reports, this person on Kiwi Farms threw the gauntlet out. Phil basically tried to wipe it away from history, which he's been doing a lot over the span of, you know, in the last 16 days of this year, trying to revise his own history. Put his ears in it, put his fingers in his ear, hoping that it would all go away. Ladies and gentlemen, your problems do not go away like that. Now, we have some, now Doom has been keeping us up to date. 16 hours ago, apparently, Phil went ahead and had a forum post as well as a twit longer that did drop Brightside Viking's name, but didn't actually mentioned that Brightside Viking was responsible for the doxing. You know, the supposed doxing that never really happened, because my website is so secure. It's those other websites that are dangerous, ladies and gentlemen. You shouldn't go to them. Kids, don't go to these other websites. They're horrible. If you go to those detractor websites, those detractor forums, you're going to get doxed. But not over here. Your Uncle Phil, he only has your email address. I have nothing else. I cannot hurt you. I care about you. It's those pesky detractors and haters and trolls that want to get you. Anyway, now, with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, the deal was with the gentleman on Kiwi Farms was that you would denounce Brightside Viking live on his stream. He didn't do that. He did it on Twitter instead. But apparently, our Dark Avenger on Kiwi Farms was appeased by this. He was like, fine, whatever. You know, it is what it is. That was 18 hours ago. 17 hours ago, an update, yet again by Doom. It appears that the doxing has stopped. It appears that we've only had one casualty, I think, up to this point. I don't think we've had any more than that. I think we had one casualty of war, and we realized that enough blood has been spilled. Phil is like, you know, it is what it is. And this person had accepted Phil's basically public service announcement. So everything should be all good. Everything should be great. Everything should be well. You would think, right? Well, ladies and gentlemen, as you know, in the world of DSP, nothing's ever the way it appears to be. Let's go ahead and move on to our next page. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, 6 hours ago, in the past 12 hours, I should say, things kind of went awry. Yet again, Doom has decided to set us up and basically decided to keep us informed. It seems like over the past 12 hours has been a bit of a roller coaster for various reasons. One, Phil released his public service announcement that somewhat name dropped Brightside Viking, although he did not admit Brightside Viking. He did not mention what Brightside Viking did and threw KG under the bus for some interesting reason. Now, if you guys know who KG is, and whatnot, you know what his history is. So we won't go into that. I'm sure you guys know. If not, don't worry. Someone in the comment section will bring you up to speed. With that being said, the person who actually initiated the bloodletting from Kiwi Farms accepted Phil's public service announcement, that making him the bigger man than Phil, and the bloodletting was canceled. You would think that's a great thing, but then things apparently go for a turn for the worse. Because, ladies and gentlemen, as I've always tried to illustrate on this channel, Phil is not wired like us. He realized something was wrong, he tried to deny it until it started to hurt him, and then all of a sudden he wants to come on his knees begging and pleading. But he can't do it the way he was ordered to. He had to do it in a half-assed way. And even then he was still cut a break. But then Phil somehow still figured out a way to fuck it up. Let me explain. Apparently, Phil couldn't even wait a single day, until he screwed things up. And with that being said, and Phil has decided to go ahead and retract his public service announcement. We don't know if the bloodletting will continue because of that, but apparently an argument broke out between BSV and King Jezel, or Jevil, I hope I'm pronouncing his name right, on Twitter, which, to be honest with you, was an actual interesting back and forth. Very interesting, actually. I will give you a little bit of what King Jevil, or Jezel, had said, and we'll go into the report. With that being said, and Doom leaves the edit right here, it looks like at 11:30 Pacific Standard Time, the harvest will begin, as usual. And the harvest, as some of you have said in the comment section, was bountiful. Very bountiful. And it appears it's going to continue, because the king needs to eat. The king needs to eat. So let's go ahead and get into it. Now, the pleads of KJ, or King Jezel, was rather straightforward. It was basically, can we please put an end to this? Please, for God's sake, saying this to DSP and Brightside Viking, please, let's just put an end to this. You have no reason to post on Kiwi Farms anymore from here on out. Let's just let it go. From here on out, let's just leave these people alone. Now, at the time that this was archived, if Brightside Viking was the first one to respond to King Jezel, it's gone. I can't see it. It's that tweet is unavailable. But whatever he said caused Phil to say, no one said you did anything wrong. They think you did something that you may have not. Here's the thing. Just stop going into detractor areas and hitting the hornet's nest. Now, that's interesting wording, because I'm pretty sure I said he needs to stop kicking the hornet's nest too. I would say great minds think alike, but I don't want to give Phil any credit. But he's like, I cannot have my life and my business, ladies and gentlemen, you're paying business taxes, you might as well go ahead and go all out with it, as well as the well-being of my viewers to be at risk because you can't control yourself. So stop. After that, it becomes a bit of back and forth between Brightside and Phil. Everything will be in the video because, as you guys all know, we need receipts. And we'll go from there. You guys will get to see everything in real time. With that also being said, though, ladies and gentlemen, things get a bit more interesting in a way that I feel is a bit unnecessary. I'm gonna have two videos in here, one by Snor Purnell. Actually, they might both be by Snor Purnell. If not by Snor Purnell, one will be by Snor Purnell and one will be by Mr. Stuffs, talking about the actual doxing situation with Phil. You know how we do with that. We'll go through. We'll see what we can pull from that. But we're going to have a treat. I have a video from Almighty Tevin, an old one and whatnot, where Phil talks about a particular situation about doxing. In these videos that I'm going to bring up, you're going to hear Phil saying, oh, I've never participated in doxing, I don't condone that, so on and so forth, whatever, whatever, whatever. But if you guys remember, way back when, or as in how Almighty Tevin likes to say, let's take a field trip, he did threaten to dox somebody. He did say that I had somebody's information who trolled him on his website and somehow he was able to get his IP address. What? But I thought, Phil, I thought you said that if I go onto your website, I don't have to worry about my IP. You just need my email address, right? Right, 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 right. Let's go ahead and get into that one. Okay, so Let's talk a little bit about Phil's form and how he says that he doesn't have any of your personal information. The thing is that Phil, if you, let's say, for example, you have those multiplayer marathons that he likes to do sometimes, and he asks for your PSN account. He expects you to provide that information, and so he can basically go ahead and backtrack you. Phil's known for doing background checks on the people he does multiplayer events with. It's a source of paranoia that's rather sad. And not only that, but he can see your IP address from his forms. Anyone can. Well, at least amongst his moderators, I should say, have that access. It's a forum. Why wouldn't he be expected to? If Kiwi Forms, think about it. If Kiwi Forms can do it, and they doxed, allegedly, such and such, then wouldn't Phil be able to do that because he runs a forum also? So what makes you any safer on Phil's forum than you would be on this forum? Yet again, it's kind of more of the nonsense that Phil portrays, making himself seem like, you know what I'm saying? It's a sad veil of damage control that doesn't make too much sense. With that being said, ladies and gentlemen, this has bled over to a couple other places. Not exactly the whole doxing situation, or as I'm going to call it, the bloody harvest. The great harvest of January, which apparently is back on after Phil has reneged. You shouldn't have done it, Phil. You have to keep your word with these things. So, apparently, on Reddit has decided to go ahead and throw their name into this situation as it pertains to Kimberly. Hi, Kimberly. Hope you're doing well. On to Kimberly and finding out what the situation is with that. And there are quite a few threads on it. It's pretty funny, actually. Got to take a look through it. As well as Phil's blow up about donations recently, which is just a whole nother situation in itself. But as we're speaking on the lovely Kimberly, there's one more thing. I'll have receipts in the video. Apparently, someone else has decided to throw their name on the hat with that one. Someone alleges to have had an encounter with our lovely Kimberly, and apparently he walked out scarred. He walked out an unhappy camper, ladies and gentlemen. And because of that, he is looking at contacting her particular agency and wants to file charges. The receipts for that will also be in the video. You guys can kind of check it out. Make of that what you will. That was sent to me. I was certainly surprised by that. Maybe you'll get a chuckle out of it. It doesn't look like it's going to go anywhere. But I want to try to give you as much as I can. As it pertains to the whole situation in general, what you guys are really here for with this whole, the harvest, the great harvest. Phil, it's sad that someone had to fall before Phil took this seriously. And Phil couldn't afford to lose the confidence of his fan base with the fact that, oh, if the forum gets taken down, where will they go? Now, ladies and gentlemen, I want to pose a very small synopsis, theory even, on some of these circumstances as it pertains to this whole situation. Now, I was going to save that for the tax video because I still owe you guys part 3 for the taxes. We'll wait on that. Okay, we're going to wait on that then. Never mind. We'll wait on that, because now that I think about it, I'll try to tie it all together there. You guys can kind of see what I'm thinking about. But for some reason, if you put everything together from the announcement of the taxes till now, it's very, very interesting how all of that flows together. If you really think about it, you have the taxes, the new girlfriend, Kim, then we had more tax situations, then we had the fundraiser. Then all of a sudden we have Brightside Viking going out on a tantrum. We have Phil with this lack of this damage control. All of a sudden KG's thrown under the belt. All of a sudden King Jevil or Jezel, or is it King Jezel or Jevil? You know who I'm talking about. Apparently he's feeling a certain type of way about the whole situation. He just wants it to stop. You know what I'm saying? The forums are completely in disarray. I got to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, for the, what, $10,000 that he made in December, or whatever the case may be, was it worth all this? Was it really worth all of this trouble? Was it really... I guess to fill it doesn't matter. But this wasn't worth it. This really, really wasn't. As it pertains to the whole harvesting situation, we're going to call Phil out on his bullshit. And Almighty Tevin will be the one to help us, because I had to go back and I had to look back into Almighty Tevin's old videos. I knew Tevin did one. I knew it because I distinctly, it was one of the first videos I had ever watched from him. Having to do with, what's that guy's name? He was the one that Brightside Viking. Yeah, that Brightside Viking was throwing the slurs to that I was originally going to do a video on. I vaulted that video. But, yeah, I think it was Be Awesome One. And if some of you guys know who that is, then you know who that is. But when Phil said he had his information and threatened to dox him, and I knew I needed that video because that video was going to come in handy. Had to look for it. And under a recent video, who was I watching? Was it an Argent video? Shouts out to Argent, by the way. I just saw his recent video. Argent's actually doing something very smart, by the way. I'm going to sidetrack for a second. He's going to wait until this whole situation is over, basically the 23 days of the harvest, before he decides to come out and say anything. Smart move on his part, because I'm looking forward to what Argent thinks of this whole situation. But, and Theo too, because I don't know if Theo's done a video yet. If he has, I'll check it out. If he hasn't and he decides to wait also, I'll wait till then. I'm sure Tevin will wait until then. But yeah, I had to find this video, and I ended up finding it. I can't remember whose video I was under, whether I was under a Volt Boy or a David Davison video, and someone actually had it. Or someone had the link to, Almighty Tevin's video, but I wanted Phil's video too. I wanted Phil's original. And that was a bit of a trek, but I ended up finding that also. I'm going to use that for a later time and date, because that'll be interesting later on down the line. Also, before we get into GTG Radio, shouts out to D for a couple of reasons. One, and I want you guys, if you guys do not know who D is, you guys should. He's the one who made that that video talking about how Phil has changed. Great video, by the way. He launched a new series. It's called DSP Archives. And it's something that it's brilliant and it'll be extremely helpful. What D is going to do is he's going to go through the painstaking process of going back into Phil's back catalog and bringing some of that stuff to light that is interesting or could be important going forward into the future. Now, as you guys know, I initially started off this channel with going through Phil's old stuff and I had to make some transitions, but I think the way D is going to do it will be much better because you know me, I'm very long-winded and whatnot. So if a particular old video comes up, I'll probably just put that on my second channel and that'll be entertaining in its own right. But the way D is going to go about it, I think will be much more helpful and it'll be a quicker reference to all of us, to be honest with you. So I hope you guys support that, support this idea. I think he has, there must be like 3 videos out, 3 or 4, I think, so far. And so I'll leave the link to those videos in my description box. Like I said, I've seen 1 already. I think there's 2 more, maybe 3 at the time that I'm recording this. I'll link all of those in the description. Please go over to his channel. Please check him out. And just support the videos, because that stuff right there will be important and will be prevalent later on down the line. So there you go. Another one, someone sent me a video that they had actually made, which it was actually pretty good. Is that SS Zaris? I hope I'm pronouncing your name right. Yeah, I think it's SS Zaris, but if I'm pronouncing your name right, I am sorry. But you made a video that I absolutely enjoy, to be honest with you. And Snort Brunel, I think when Snort Brunel sees it, he'll be proud. Because I'm certainly very proud of it. And I'll get permission from you later on if I can use it later on down the line. Because I actually have a video idea and I'd love to be able to use it. But like I said, I'd like to run it through you. I'd like to get your okay first before I do so. But I like it. I like it a lot. I'm honored in a lot of ways that I sort of inspired you. I'm going to use the word sort of because that was your wording. But I like it. I certainly like it. And I feel there will be uses for it in the future. by all means. So like I said, if I have your permission for that, shoot me a message, and I'd very much appreciate it. I hope you don't mind, because, yeah. I will leave a link to that video also, ladies and gentlemen, in my description. I'd like you guys to go over there and take a look at it. Yeah, it's just something that you need to see. That's all I'm going to say. It's something that you need to see. With that being said, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go into GTG Radio. We've got a bunch of brand new bumps, a bunch of new brand new Adult Swim bumps. Do not worry. For all of you who have laid down music requests, they are coming. I'm waiting on a certain video that I'm waiting for a certain situation to fall into place, which it will. And I'll kind of put all that in. And so I have all of those videos written down, as well as to the people who actually recommended those videos, because I want to make sure that I give you guys your shout outs when we do that. So don't worry, your music requests are still coming. If anybody has a particular music request, by all means, leave it down in the description below. If you can leave a link to, just leave the full title down in the description below. I very much appreciate it. If you want to leave me a link to a video that may have it, that's cool too. And I'll try to get that in there for you into future videos instead of saying the next video, just to try to keep it fair. All right, guys, we're going to go into, like I said, our first music segment. We're going to go in, you're going to get like, oh, wow. You guys are going to get a lot of music today, because I just found a lot of nice stuff. I'm feeling positive, ladies and gentlemen. The last couple of videos were a bit of a dredge. You know what I'm saying? There was a lot. You know what I'm saying? It's easy for the negativity to be pulled from you. And I generally, even though I generally want to try to be serious with some of the stuff that we're talking about, because some of the stuff is very serious. And it's very important in some ways for it to be said. I also want it to be kind of lighthearted. I want you guys to kind of come here, and not only that I'm informing you and you guys are getting up to date, but also you're having a good time in some way, shape, or form. Even if you hate what I say, I would hope that at least the music is somewhat, you know, brings you guys together. Like in my last video, for example, someone said that they didn't care much for the Unusual Suspect part of it, but they seem to like the music aspect. Cool. I can live with that. It is what it is. As long as you walk away from the video with something, it helps, I think. At least for me. I feel like I don't want you to kind of come into the video and come out and be like, you didn't get anything. If that is the case, then I can't do anything. I apologize. But I'd like for you guys to generally walk away with something. So there you go. Ladies and gentlemen, this is DSP News. Always late, never breaking, unreliable coverage that you can't count on. A GTG Network and Productions. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's get to what I'd really like to get you into, some GTG Radio. So, enjoy.
good.
Sounds great.
Sadly, I had to deal with stupid bullshit this morning. That delayed me a bit. In various places, you know, I had to clean up stuff on my forums, I had to clean up stuff on the stream. And it can get pretty frustrating when...
Basically meaning erasing all the evidence. Yeah, exactly. It's like we had to... You had to delete all the evidence. You had to get all of BSV's threats. You know, you had to get that all off the forums now before the internet detectives go ahead and get it. If they don't already have it archived, of course.
All I want to do is stream games and have fun, and I got to deal with stupid drama and nonsense. Trust me, I'm 35 years old. I really don't have time for this stupid shit. I don't, but it sucks when I have to step up and deal with it, and it takes time away from what I want to do. So apologies for that, everybody.
Oh, boy. It's funny, too, because if, yet again, if Phil would just either exclude these people from his community or just nip it in the butt early, he may not have these problems. But that's neither here nor there. In truth, who controls who? Does Phil control his community, or does his community control him? They're the ones with the money. He's the one who, I need that money. I really do. I need that money to pay my bills.
Smart.
Not really. But with that being said, it merely makes you think that, like, because his fan base has the money, and because he needs the money, who really has control? It's his fan base kind of, it's funny, like the big whales in his community call the shots. Even the community at large should have probably the majority of control, because they're the ones who give the money out. And they should be able to get what they want, meaning the games that should be played without being, oh, I don't know, rage quitted, dropped, projects being derailed because the heavens told him not to do this, so on and so forth. I don't know. If you're gonna vote with your wallet, they just need to take better control of their situation. Either that or leave. Give your money to somebody else who's more worthwhile. There are plenty of streamers out there who will give you beyond quality content, which is Phil's bare minimum, will give you everything they have and some. They just want a shot. They just want a chance. They really just want to entertain you before even trying to get into your wallet. Phil wants to get into your wallet, get all of that, and then give you what he feels is his definition of entertainment. And you guys should want better. Don't you guys even think you deserve better? I don't know. If I ever get paid for this, I'll let you guys know. Let's continue.
Man, I'm stupid.
You are.
I want to cover this publicly. I talked about it on Twitter last night. I'm going to talk about it again. In particular, to you guys who are regular stream attendees, you guys and gals are very awesome. You guys have a lot of fun with me on a daily basis. You share gameplay experiences with me. We interact on stream, right? You guys, some of you, cheer, sub, and tip, and I'm greatly appreciative for that, okay? But... I gotta be honest, and I gotta talk up front about some stuff for your own safety and protection. I feel that every once in a while, as a PSA, I should probably address these kind of stuff. Alright, so let's go ahead and talk about it.
And don't lie. Do not lie. Please do not lie. And let your fan base know that they're in much bigger trouble than they know. Let's just be honest, ladies and gentlemen. Oh boy. And basically, it was Kiwi Farm saying...
Oh my god! What the fuck?
Exactly. Basically what it was Kiwi Farm's throwing down the gauntlet. Basically being like, hey, clean up this little bullshit mess that you've allowed to roll over, you know, over here, Phil, or we'll clean it up for you. And in turn, by cleaning up what this one guy here was doing, they were going to basically clean up his whole website, too. They were just going to clear them all out. They were going to basically do the internet a favor and just wipe the King of Hate forums just off the internet, essentially. And Phil, in his own arrogance, because that's how Phil is, he couldn't allow that to happen. He's scared, but he really needs that forum because it's like really the only place they can kind of congregate, except for his streams. And even then, his streams are just kind of... It's you know what I'm saying? You're gonna get banned off his streams super quickly. You know what I'm saying? You have a better chance lasting on the forums and saying I fucked his former daughter more than you do on his chat. And his chat, the ban hammer just comes so quickly. You know what I mean? It's like whack-a-mole over there. And everybody can get it.
FYI, folks, sometimes if you're a fan of mine or a viewer and, you know, you're being positive and supportive in various ways, whether it's just, you know, being a viewer and saying nice stuff in the stream chat and participating with other chatters, or if it's your cheer sub or tip, whatever it may be, sometimes you'll notice you get harassed. It happens. It's the fucking internet, right? I mean, there's people out there who just have nothing better to do with their lives than to obsess over people on the internet, and when they see someone supporting someone they don't like, they're gonna attack them, okay? So, as a PSA, here's a few things that I feel that I should let you know. Number one, if you get attacked by someone, don't take it personally and don't take it seriously. What I do is I think about the situation this person must be in their life, that they're so uptight and they're so obsessed, right? That someone who's interacting with me on a stream would actually, you know, be messaged or bothered by someone. It's just ludicrous to me. Most people with intelligent brains, brains that work, that are hinged properly, right, or screwed in correctly, don't do that kind of shit. We realize how dumb that is, how immature, how feral, how, you know, drama-esque that kind of shit is. You don't do that. That, you know, if you like the person, you watch their stuff. If you don't like the person, you do what else you're gonna do, right? You don't bother with that shit. It's such a waste of time. So that being said, normal people wouldn't do that shit. So I just think, man, that poor person must be so screwed in their head that they would do shit like this, right?
It's Darth Vader being Viking with...
I kind of feel bad for him. I honestly do. You gotta kind of approach it like that. Don't approach this man as an annoying troll. Like,
what? Okay, first off, you what? You have to worry about what they're going through at the time? You mean those mentally ill idiots that are always running around, Phil? You mean that? You mean that? You mean these people that the white coats need to come and get? You mean that? It's funny how Phil talks about mental illness like that, right? And in truth, Phil himself probably suffers from some type of mental illness. And one of the more prevailing theories is that he does that to cover up his own shortcomings. I don't mean the fact that he's a piece of shit. I mean the fact that he may actually have a mental illness himself. And he lashes out using that as a defense mechanism. Because, in truth, ladies and gentlemen, there's nobody this stupid. It's just not possible. It's not possible that you get into the trouble that you get into and you can't figure out a way out. You can't figure out a way out. That was a pretty good metaphor, actually. Anyway, you know what I'm saying? I should try to use that later. But yeah, there's no way that happens. There's no way that you act the way you do and not have a problem with you. You know what I mean? You got to understand that the detractor community is here to point your shit out. Do some people take it too far? Like myself? Sure. Sure. But at the same time, I don't have people from this side over here that are doxing you or threaten or death, or actually, let's scratch the doxing part, but sending death threats your way, Phil, or to anybody in your community. And this whole situation about, hey Phil, I showed up to your stream and I donated some money and then all these people started shitting on me. Where's the paperwork then? Where's the proof? Where's your screenshots? Where's any of that? It's funny how you're starting to hear these little claims come out and yet we don't see it. Like, if that was really happening to you and you're a Phil fan, you would bring out the paperwork. Or as Almighty Tevin would say, you would have some receipts. So where are your receipts? You know what I mean? Like, it's almost like trying to feed into Phil's narrative, and then that feeds into Phil's own ego. But in truth, this all comes back down to Phil. It is Phil's fault. It is. The bloodletting will continue, ladies and gentlemen. Children of the Corn is going to continue to happen. It's just the way it is. Children of the Corn, I like that. It's actually a pretty good movie, too. They made too many of them, but it is what it is. So, yeah. Let's continue.
Man, this person, they're in a bad way, okay? So that's number one. Don't get all upset about it. It's nothing to be upset about. It's just an idiot. It's just someone who needs help, okay?
Now, it's also one more thing. I kind of went off on a tangent there. Phil, he's your attack dog. He's one of a pack of attack dogs, actually. They've been known to do some dirt like this for a while. I don't know if they've gone as far as BSV did. I don't know about that. You know, they've done their, I know for sure they've all done their dirt in some way, shape, or form. I don't know if they've gone as far as Brightside has, or Vidal, or whatever he's calling by now. But yet again, you knew about all those things because you had your little chuckles about them. You should have probably pinched that shit in the ass right then and there. You let it carry on too long because you used them as a shield. That's really what they were, to try to isolate yourself from the situation. Hey, I had nothing to do with that. That was them. Talk to them. And now that shit's starting to become blowback, now you don't want no parts of it. Same thing with this alleged girlfriend. If she exists, she's going to be nothing more than a shield. You're expecting people to shit on her like they did Leanna. And you'll just sit back in the back and be like, oh, I'm sorry, sweetie. It's the way it is. Even though, yet again, another prevailing argument is that you're not telling the truth to her, if she exists, of the trouble that you're really in, the problems that you deal with on a daily basis. So essentially, you're bringing this young lady to her demise. I'm hoping that wording doesn't come back to bite me later. But you're bringing her essentially to her own demise to protect yourself. That's not love, Phil. And are we really willing to make another blood sacrifice of another young lady for what? For ego? For arrogance? Is that all she's worth? What are you going to do, Phil? She's going to cook and clean and do this and that and third for a little while and that's it? But we're not going to get into that fully. Someone else has already done a video talking about how much she loves to clean. They sent that to me. They asked if I would do it. I will. It won't be in this particular video, but it'll be in the next. Hopefully. Hopefully by the weekend it'll be out. DSP News.
Number two. FYI, if it happens here on Twitch, if you're warned, okay? If it does happen on Twitch, okay, you can block the person. In addition, if you click on their name, you can report them to Twitch and have them banned from the site, which you should absolutely do, especially if the stuff they're saying to you is very offensive. And if you see that they're also in the stream chat, just notify a mod. And the mods will look into it and possibly, you know, get them on a stream chat too to make sure that they don't stink up the stream chat as well. Okay.
Now see, here's the problem with that. Now that's YouTube heroes all over again. Now you're basically giving people provocation to just go ahead and be like, hey, ban that person. Did they say something bad about Phil? Did I miss something? Just go ahead and get him out of here, man. I'm catching a bad vibe off him. Man, not even had anything to do with Phil. They may have had a separate conversation amongst themselves and that shit went left. And then all of a sudden you're getting people banned. Yet again, Phil, you've created the petri dish so these people can basically eat each other. Essentially, it's this. What is it? Sharks. There we go. Sharks in the womb, pups as they call them, eat each other, or have been known to eat each other while they're inside the womb, and only the strongest ones come out. You're doing the exact same thing. The problem is though, is the ones that survive will be weak. Because guess what, Phil? The sharks are not in your community. The sharks are out here with the detractors, the haters, the trolls. We're the real apex predators out here. Not in your streams. Not on your forums. The real predators are out here. And if they don't act right, then that's when they go learn how to act right. And you only get one. You only get a couple shots at that. To be honest with you, the fact that Brightside made it as far as he did surprises me. But he did, so it is what it is. Let's continue.
If you want to be careful in the modern era, you gotta be careful what you put out on the internet about yourself. This includes not only hearing Twitch stream chat, okay? This includes on other websites, on social media. You gotta be careful because some people say, it's all safe, right? So I'll put, I'm Joe from Hoboken, New Jersey, and here's a picture of me in my work shirt of where I work. That is a terrible idea. Terrible, trust me, guys. From someone who has nothing but a public persona, for the past 10 years,
I gotta take a steaming dump right now.
And seeing the shit that people have done to me, and knowing that now, more than ever, people can look at your footprint on the internet, okay? Research.
What's wrong, Phil? You got a loss for words? Oh, because you've done that too. What? Allegedly, you've done that to more than one person looking up IPs? Oh, you didn't dox them, but you looked up their information. You have it in a file somewhere, right? Allegedly, right? Allegedly, a couple of your mods have some background information on some people somewhere in a file? Allegedly? Allegedly. Oh, okay. But it's so dangerous, right, Phil? shouldn't put your personal information out there, right, Phil? Even though allegedly, that every other person on your forums you have direct information to, or you have someone who has direct access to that information. Allegedly. Just saying. Very dangerous. Yeah. Keep this in mind, ladies and gentlemen. Everything this man touches turns to shit. There's no getting around that. It's the way it is. Be careful. He's not one to be trusted, and until he gives you a reason, and trust me, he can't, you should just stay away from him in general. The sad thing is, if any of you, has been involved with his forums in any way, shape, or form, you've already been compromised. It is what it is. Don't fall for the broke man gout Jedi mind tricks about, oh, don't go over to those forums, they've got you exposed. You've already been exposed. You've already been exposed. That's how the bloody harvest, as we've been calling it over here, has come about. On Kiwi Farms, they call it the January harvest. But I like to call it the bloody harvest. Because, to be honest with you, this won't be the only bloodletting of the year. I'm not saying I have inside information. I'm not saying that's what I was told. I have a feeling. There's going to be a whole lot of blood that's going to be laid out before things are said or done. Figuratively speaking, I'm not saying that we'll ever see anything like that. Just saying.
Shit like that. They could find stuff out about you, okay? It's pretty fucked up how much people can actually find out about someone just by looking a few clicks around the internet, okay? Being real with you guys, I know for a fact there's some...
I don't know. Now that I think about it, outside of myself, Tyrone, and Pedro, Panda's done a pretty good job of keeping herself off the radar. Just saying. I mean, then again, she was exposed for like 5 years, and I mean, the trauma that she had, I mean, goddamn, man, it's the equivalent of going to war, you know what I mean, and coming back home finally. She was a POW, if you think about it. Good God, we should... That young woman needs some sympathy. She really does. She's been through a lot. You know what I mean? You have to fight off a lot. Being with Phil is consistently being in a war zone. But that's neither here nor there. Point is no one's found her. She's isolated herself pretty well, so, you know, you just gotta be smart. Not like Phil, though. Not like Phil.
People that they have shit on the internet, and then someone gets pissed at them for whatever reason, within 25 minutes, they found out all kinds of personal shit about them, and next thing you know, you're getting trolled.
Oh, what do you mean, Phil? Like how you take people's money and leave them with the bag? How you shit on people for no reason? How you shit on people for giving you good advice? How you shit on people who try to warn you about situations? What is it, Phil? You've shitted on people for a lot of things. There have been a lot of people who try to hold you down, who try to let you know about certain situations. Remember that whole, oh, I have people out there that let me know about stuff, or people who may try to hurt me, this, that, and the third. You've had quite a few people who try to help you out, and you toss them under the bus later on. Interesting. So, who really needs to be careful, Phil? You know what I mean? I think, yet again, you are, as people have said, you are your greatest detractor. By far. There's not a single person in the history of your life who have done more damage to you than yourself. It is what it is. No one. Not at all. There is not a single living person that could say that they've done enough damage to Philip Brunel than himself. It's just not possible. It's not possible. And as long as you stay in denial and you keep treating it like the whole world's against you, then other people will fall onto the sword for you until the day that you inevitably will fall on the sword yourself. It is what it is. No one has any real value to you. You will throw anybody and everybody under the bus to save your own bacon. The problem is, Phil, is your bacon's already overcooked. It's almost done. it's almost over. You know what you do, and you know what people do with food that they're no longer concerned with. You know what people do to other people that they no longer value. You of all people know that. They'll be discarded. You're right there in line too, Phil. Every person that you've ever cut out of your life, the moment that their usefulness to you weighed out, it's going to happen to you too. Because when you treat people that way, it always comes back on you. That's one of the reasons why you don't believe in karma. But we'll talk about that later.
In real life, and you're like, what the fuck is this? You know, all I did was you know, make a post on Twitter, and now I got assholes coming after me, right? You obviously don't want that, right? So, just a forewarning that what you put on the internet can easily be accessed, all right? Now, just to warn you guys, yeah, I mean, I forgot to warn you guys, but to reassure you guys, anything that you guys do in relation to me.
See how he told the truth there, and then he backtracked? Oh, just to warn you guys. I mean, to reassure you guys. You guys aren't in any danger. I'm just trying to reassure you guys. Reassure. He blatantly lied when he could have told the truth. He should have been honest with them and be like, hey, there's certain information on my site that I do have access to. I have no intention of using it, nor do anybody that's associated with my site, my mods, my administrators, so on and so forth. But we do have access to it. And we will do the best within our own ability to make sure that no one else can get access to it. That's what he should have said. Instead, he's going to say this.
Meaning, let's say, for example, you're a chatter here on my stream chat. Or let's say you registered on my forums and you post over there or whatever. That's all. Don't worry about that. That stuff's good.
That's 100% a lie.
Yep.
I'm good at lying.
Not really.
You never have to worry that, oh man, because I'm doing something with DSP that my personal info can get out or whatever. You know, I don't have any of your info anyway. The only info I ever have on you guys and gals who watch my stuff is your email address, maybe if you registered for my website, right? And that's not a big deal. You know, nothing. I have nothing of real importance at all. Some people seem to be under the effect that because they, like, registered for a website that I can have their phone number and shit.
Why would they even say that? But see, do you guys catch the code, though, for that? Oh, people think that if they register to a website, I have their phone number. No, you don't have their phone number, but you do have their IP. Which just happens to be in numbers, right, Phil? But the phone number thing was better. Because you think these people are stupid, so it's like, oh, well, I can tell a half-truth and I'll play off that. Yeah, that'll work. So even on a subconscious level, Phil can barely lie. Barely. And he knows, and this is the more egregious aspect of it, he knows he put these people at jeopardy. He knows he put these kids in jeopardy. But the harvest is going to continue. Let's continue.
You're crazy. No way. You know, that's not how it works. But some people get paranoid, okay? You don't have to worry about that. But what I'm saying is, be careful what you put out there. Because you'd be very surprised via Facebook in particular. Oh, my God.
Oh, so it's not your fault, Phil. It's their fault. Oh, you guys need to take responsibility for the situation. Not me. I'm sorry that one of my boys went rogue again and decided to go ahead and mess with the wrong people, and now all of a sudden they're going to go ahead and let the bloodletting flow. But that's your fault, though. So you guys are responsible for that. So you guys in the future need to go ahead and take the steps needed to protect yourselves. Because I will take no personal responsibility for that. As long as my piggy bank continues to do what he does, oink, oink, I'm good. You guys need to protect yourselves, though, because I'm already out there. So you guys got to take care of you. It's essentially, I'd like to say Jay-Z, but I mean, as the more and more you look into the Jay-Z situation, I can't necessarily blame, I may have not liked the way Jay went about it and whatnot when he did what he did, but I mean, that was business, I guess. You know what I'm saying? And I may have not liked how he did it, but I understand. But we'll talk about that later. I'm sorry, I'm sidetracking. I should probably just lay that situation out just to give you guys a point of reference, but you know, we'll talk about that later.
Facebook is like the number one source for people to get personal info on people, because they'll look at all your pictures on Facebook. They'll do crazy shit. Okay, now, trust it. From me, I don't even use Facebook. I use Instagram. The shit that people have done with the pictures I post on Instagram to try to figure shit out. You know what I mean? They could really deep dive into that shit. So be very careful.
Then stop putting shit online. See, okay, ladies and gentlemen, here's the problem. Anything that you put out in turn could be considered as, could put you at risk, okay, whether you do something or not. But when you're someone like Phil, who makes it his daily routine to shit on other people for his own amusement, he's mad that he can essentially smack you and then you smack him back. That's essentially how Phil is. oh, well, you know, I said this, but I don't understand why you guys reacted that way. You guys didn't need to do all that. Why you guys bothered me? Why'd you guys do that? Phil, when you call somebody a psychotic piece of shit and fuck you, I'm banning you from my forums, most people will let that go. Most people will sit there and be like, well, fuck him. And then most people will take it to the next step and really try to put the screws to you. It's the internet. It's how it happens. Every little thing that you do can be spun in a certain type of way depending on how you do it. Don't sit there and be burning bridges if you have to walk across that bridge. How hard is it to be a decent human being every day? Not when it just suits you, just every day. It's not that hard. Maybe it is. I don't know. I'd say generally the rest of us are doing all right. Just saying. I don't hurl any death threats at anybody and nobody's coming after me. It kind of works out. I don't see a need to threaten a man, his wife, and his children. And in turn, he doesn't feel the need to go ahead and basically retaliate. Last time I checked, 2 and 2 make 4. And also the last time I checked, 10% of nothing is Jesus, still nothing. I'm sorry. So how hard is this? Keep your eye on the money, I guess.
All right. With what you put out there, again, this is a PSA. I care about you guys.
I know you're lying.
I don't want to see anyone get negatively affected.
I care about you guys? That's the biggest lie of this year. I'm disgusted that you said that, Phil. Disgusted.
By some idiots who are actively searching the internet for, you know, things to use against people, all right? Last but not least, folks, and this is an important one for everyone, all right? Even for me, this is an important one, and I gotta do my best to live up to this one as well, all right? When you see these kind of negative people on the internet who do nothing but waste their time trying to hate on me and obsess about me and do nasty shit about me, the best course of action when you see someone like that is not to engage them and argue with them and attack them or do anything to do with them.
Wait a second. What happened to all those years about, oh, that guy right there, I give you permission to flood his PSN account to the point that he can't do anything. What happened to that, Phil? What happened to that whole, I give you guys permission to lambast that person for ever thinking that he could talk to me that way? What happened about that situation, Phil? You guys can treat that guy like absolute trash and get him and run him off of my chat and off of my forums for the stuff that he said and done to me. What happened about that, Phil? What happened about those examples? What happened about those situations? I'm waiting. Oh, you need a minute? I'll wait. Let's continue.
It's to avoid them completely and ignore them. Because the bottom line is, folks, if all of us just basically kind of ignored it and just came to the streams daily and have fun interacting with each other and enjoying the gameplay, right? And that's, if that's all that we focused on and that's all we cared about, none of that other shit would ever affect us nor matter. The problem is that people fall into the black hole of drama that is the internet.
These people are pieces of human shit. This guy fucking sucks my dick. You suck my dick. You suck my dick. I got paid for your stupidity. Thanks for the money, dummies. Thanks for the money, stupid fuck. Bumble fucks. Fucking idiots. They're dumb fucks. Time for me to start losing more fucking hair. I got completely exposed.
And listen, I'm not immune to it as well. There's been times when I've fallen, I sucked right into the toilet of the negative drama internet, you know, flushed right down into the fucking toxic sewers. And it's bad, man. It's bad. It's bad that that happens. And, you know, it's bad that, sadly, some people...
That's all you can say? It's bad that it happens? It's bad that it happens. It's not, hey, I fell into this, I shouldn't have fallen into this, learn from my example. You couldn't even say that. You couldn't even bring yourself to say that because you're looking to justify why you did it. Right, Phil? I mean, that's really what you want to say. But you're not ready to do it yet because you haven't been triggered to do that yet. You haven't been prompt to do that yet. This is terrible. I can see why you went back on your deal. I can see that.
Well, you know, you get negatively affected by it, all right? I talked about this on Twitter last night, but I'll reiterate it. If you go to some website where people are known for being nasty about me constantly, and you register on that website, your info is not safe. Whatever login, whatever password, whatever you use to log into that website, they'll use against you, okay?
Like they did Brightside Viking. Because he's on QE Forums. I guess he's no safer than anybody else. Right?
They will look at your IP address. Yes, any website that uses a forum where you log in, they have your IP.
Wait a second. I thought you said that your website was safe, though. I thought you said all you had was an email address. Your website is a forum, isn't it? Really? Lie to me some more, Phil. Please. At least try a little harder. God damn. I'm insulted. Insulted about this. Someone please get Volt Boy on the phone. I'm rather salty right now. Maybe he could use it. Well, no. Volt Boy has a lot of salt already. Someone get SJ Cruz on the phone. I had a chance to talk to him the other day. Nice guy, by the way. Very nice guy. Someone get him on the phone. See if he doesn't mind some salt. I got a lot of salt here. I feel the need to spread it around.
Address. Now, can they do anything with that in particular? Not really. They could probably generally get the area of the country you live in. A lot of the times, it's not even accurate. Like, I've personally searched my own IP address, and it's wrong. It'll tell me that I'm, like, somewhere else. So, it's not that big of a deal. It's not specific.
I'm gonna let you go on that blatant lie there. I'm gonna let you go on that, sir. I'm gonna let you go on that.
It's not like, oh, I have your IP address. Now I know your name, your address, your phone number, your social security number. No, it's nothing like that. But still, you know, giving out your IP address like that isn't a great idea if for someone who's gonna use it for malicious purposes, all right?
What? You just said that they can't do anything with it, but no, we're gonna bring that back. I'm sorry. I'm gonna call you out on this one. This video is already gonna be long, but we're gonna make it worthwhile, ladies and gentlemen.
Of the times it's not even accurate. Like I've personally,
we're gonna bring this one back. I'm mad that you did that.
Website, your info is not safe. Whatever login, whatever password, whatever you use to log into that website, they'll use against you. Okay, they will look at your IP address. Yes, any website that uses a forum where you log in, they have your IP address. Now, can they do anything with that in particular? Not really. They could probably generally get the area of the country you live in. A lot of the times it's not even accurate. Like I've personally searched my own IP address and it's wrong. It'll tell me that I'm like somewhere else. So, it's not that big of a deal. It's not specific. It's not like, oh, I have your IP address. Now I know your name, your address, your phone number, your social security number. No, it's nothing like that. But still, you know, giving out your IP address like that isn't a great idea if for someone who's going to use it for malicious purposes, all right?
So which one is it? It's useless or it can hurt you? And see, this is why people say, or this is why people feel also, that he's dangerous. Because the misinformation that he gives out is retarded. It's absolutely retarded. And you're putting all these people at jeopardy for what? To make yourself feel better? All right.
So you gotta be careful. All right. You know, where you go and what you register for, you really do. It's not like it used to be. Things on the internet have gotten pretty damn nasty with toxic people.
Why am I toxic?
Good question.
All right. So, you know, you just gotta be careful. And, you know,
He doesn't even have any words. When have you guys heard Phil be this speechless? To the point where he doesn't really have anything to say. At all. Like, the man's just literally boxed into a corner. Terrible.
I'm gonna be honest with you guys. I've been sucked into it as well, okay? And I know people who've gotten sucked into it. I'm not gonna be here and stand on a soapbox and say, how dare you? You should be more mature. Because the bottom line is, it's easy to get sucked in. It is. But you gotta, trust me, from someone who's now been through this for 10 straight years, there's no positive thing that could possibly come out of wasting your time with it. There's nothing. It's a complete waste of time. You will never convince a single person on the internet who dislikes me to not dislike me. It will never happen. You're just blowing smoke up your own ass if you believe that. Let these people do what they want to do and obsess however they want to obsess, and let them do it in their own places. And, you know, come to the safe places to come hang out with us and have fun.
Where are they safe, Phil? Phil, let's break things down for just a second, Phil. In all honesty, we're gonna talk about some, and we're gonna do it in a way that some of your own people, Brightside Viking, for example, has done it. Sock accounts for days. You ban one, I have 10 more coming at you. They're already logged in. They're already coming right at your headpiece. That's your forums. That's your chat. That's your YouTube pages. Where are you safe, Phil? You're not safe anywhere. And you're not safe because you constantly and consistently dare people to come get you. You talk all this nonsense about, oh, I just want to be left alone. Oh, I just want to play games and have fun. Oh, I just want to share my experiences. AKA, you guys give me money and I give you the bare minimum. Oh, I just want to have this little piece for myself. I don't want to be rich. I don't want to be one of the top YouTubers. I don't want to have fame. I just want to be here, okay, make YouTube videos for you guys and have my daughter. I mean, I'm sorry. Have my ex-girlfriend / maid wait on me hand and foot while I sit there and play video games on my ass. You say that's all you want, but then you go on these little tirades on your pre-streams, which are getting longer and longer. Shit, damn near getting as long as my videos at times. Or you're sitting here getting on Twitter and going on these small little tirades about dumb shit that means nothing to nobody. And it's just fueling the consistent fire. Because eventually someone's going to feel a certain type of way about it. And at the end of the day, you get burned. Well, someone else gets burned for you. And then when they come to you and cry, boo-boo, you look at them and be like, hey, why were you over there playing next to the fire then? You can't just keep running. You can't. You're too old to be doing this. That's the thing. You're too old to be trying to engage with people like this online. You're too old to be sending the wolves, or the attack dogs, really, out there and not expect repercussions. You say that you've been doing this for 10 straight years. That's 10 years of people seeing your bullshit shenanigans and knowing exactly where to hit you. And where is it that you hit Phil? You hit him in every place that either can make him money or that touches his heart. Which in truth means touches his ego. And it's the few things that he owns. His girlfriend, which is no longer his girlfriend anymore. She's free with Tyrone and Pedro. There's his little forums, which he was damn near willing to let, you know, go on fire. You know what I'm saying? To save his piggy bank. His piggy bank, who decided to put himself out there and get bacon cut off his back. And then Twitch. Which at the end of the day, he can't afford, in my own personal opinion, he can't afford for his website to fall. Because if his website falls, he knows they'll come after Twitch next. You want to know why that is? Because he screwed YouTube over himself. You guys can say whatever you guys want about, oh, well, they did this, that, and the third. And you wouldn't be wrong. But who was the idiot that sat there and deleted 400 to 600 videos to wipe 3 million views off of his channel? And in turn, cutting himself out of YouTube search. Who was the idiot who sat there and ran his goddamn mouth and said, you guys will wait on me hand and foot because I have a managed partnership and you will do what I say when I say it and you will bring this up to management right now, and got himself fired? Who was that? And you want to know why all of those things worked out? Because Phil reacts. That's all he knows how to do. He's reactive. That's all he does. And that hurts him more than anything. And here's the funny part. People know what to make him react. And that's the thing that he doesn't realize. And that's the point that one of you in a private message actually sent me. Because I've been saying, who is the puppet or who's the puppeteer? And one of you guys actually caught it. Actually, a lot of you caught it, but this was the only person who actually messaged me back. That at the end of the day, we're the puppeteers, and he's the puppet. The only problem is, he hasn't figured that out yet. And in turn, That's why this stuff happens. That's why all of this drama happens. That's why it's been happening. And it'll continue to happen. Because people understand how Phil works. Better than he does. Better than the people in his inner circle do. Even though some of those members aren't stupid. They realize what Phil is going to do when a situation comes up. But Phil never addresses it until it hurts him. He'll throw anybody and everybody to the wolves to save his own bacon. And that's destructive. And you don't need to be around people like that. You need to cut people like that out of your life, to be honest with you. Because it's like somebody who's drowning. They'll drown. They will bring you down with them. It's just a wiring, I guess. You know what I mean? Some people are calm and some people aren't. And the ones that aren't will drown you also. And some people, like Phil, to be honest, can't be saved. He just can't. He can't. He really can't. He's been in the deep end for a long ass time. He's eaten a little too much. He's cramped up once too many times. And people told him, you've had one too many gin and sprites. And he decided to go into the deep end anyway. And then there you go. DSP News.
All right. So, you know, come to the stream chat.
Come watch me and give me monies. And if you don't, I'll have no life and no way to make money. That's what I'm all about, okay? That's what I'm all about.
That's good stuff. Don't go to these negative places. Don't engage these people on Twitter or Facebook or other social media. It ain't worth it. As much, you know, people call it white knighting, all right? I'm going to stick up for this person who otherwise it seems like they can't really have any defense for themselves because they're a public persona, and I'm going to stick up for them. And listen, I understand that you guys are maybe big fans of mine and loyal fans and viewers, and you like what I do. You stick up for me. You feel I'm a good person, and you want to stick up for me. You want to stick up for me the best way you can do it, be here on stream every day, watch, enjoy, engage with me, and have fun. That's how you can do it.
You son of a bitch. So if you guys want a white knight for me, come to my streams every day, sub, tip, give me bits, donate, Teespring, basically give me your money. Give me your time and your money, and that's how you can support me every day. And then he gets mad that he gets called out on this shit. You greedy, greedy, greedy bastard. You greedy bastard.
Outside of this safer space to the place.
Oh, my bad. I'm sorry. I was kind of in my own little tizzy there. This is Snort Brunel, one of the greatest DSP gaming addressing new drama and Pig Roach style, the PR cult versus Kiwi Farms. Sorry about that.
This is where these people lurk. The disgusting, toxic, you know, sewers of the internet is not a good idea. Okay? It's not. It's all it's going to do is in the long run, is cause more drama and hurt you in the long run. Okay?
You don't want to be butt-fucked. Trust me on this. I know. Oh my god! Oh!
I don't want to hear, oh my god, I'm a fan of DSP, and I went to this detractor website, and I tried to stick up for him, and now they're harassing me constantly every single day nonstop. Man, that's horrible. I don't want to hear that, you know? And certainly there's nothing I can do to prevent that either. So you just gotta be careful, guys, okay? Super Cat Meow in the stream chat just said, I have to respectfully disagree. I used to be a detractor, but I don't hate you anymore. I feel that you're not what others say you are.
Someone who doesn't deserve any popularity on YouTube because he's a bad person, because this is how he plays games. He doesn't respect game developers. He just insults them constantly. Yep. That's what Phil is. He's a bad person. He's a bad gamer. Yep. And but here's the evidence. Look at this. This is how you don't play video for this game. Mm-hmm. Terrible. He's a dinosaur of the internet. He's done.
Yep.
Look at this. He's falling apart. Phil had an escort, and he's trying to pay the escort.
Allegedly.
That's what the fundraising stream is on
more
Saturday.
Likely.
Phil is a pedophile. Phil is a thief and a liar who steals from his fans constantly. Phil's a faggot.
Yep.
Phil's fat.
Yep.
Phil's a loser. Yep. Phil's a beggar. Mm-hmm. DSP is a pedophile. DSP is a thief. DSP is a greedy fuck. I have a micro penis. Oh. Phil has gouty, fat butt. Oh. I'm gay, totally gay.
Oh. He was the guy that called. caught masturbating in front of children.
That's right, I'm a huge pervert, guys. I'm Hitler.
Oh my god.
I'm a very fallible, very, very fragile, very, you know, vulnerable person. Everyone knows that. I'm a pedophile. I have zero life, by the way. Zero. Literally zero. Everyone always says I'm fat. I'm so mentally fucked in my head. As we know, everyone out there who's ever attacked me or said something negative about me is 100% true. And it's all just completely legitimate stuff. And it's because these people are such creative and positive people that they put this stuff onto YouTube, right?
Now, here's the cool thing.
Okay, first off, that little bit there was amazing. Well done to Snorper now. The only thing that I have to say as it pertains to that, the only thing that would make that perfect, that would be just the cherry on top, right? If he had the sound bite where he says, what did he actually say? It was there's like a tad bit of truth to everything that's said about him. I wish that little bit was added to that, Snorpernell. Just that little bit, right at the end. Just that little bit. That would top that off perfectly. But, yeah, that's just my opinion. that's just my opinion.
There are people like that, and I'm aware of that. There are people who have come out and said, listen, Phil, I used to actually hate your guts because all I did was follow negative people who said negative shit about you. And then I actually came and checked you out and hung out for a little bit, and now I like your stuff, and, you're a cool guy. You're not what they say. I know.
It's funny, too, because Phil wanted to say you're a good guy, but he decided not to. Smart move on your part, Phil, because people would call the hell out of you on that one.
And I appreciate that, but you have to understand that you are the exception to the rule. And I'm pretty certain the reason that people like that come around isn't because someone adamantly kept screaming at them, no, Phil's good, Phil's nice, Phil's good. It was more because you kind of came around by yourself, realized, you were intelligent enough to see through the cultish mentality. You stopped drinking the Kool-Aid, you came over, you saw me play a game, you're like, oh shit, this is actually pretty good.
What?
Tamanice just said,
you know what that sounds like? That sounds like a sick bear. Like, that's not a laugh. I don't know what that is. It's like hearing a walrus give out a death throw. I may watch too much Animal Channel. Don't judge me. I don't know what that is. It sounds like an animal dying. A horrible, horrible, slow death. That's what it sounds like. It's so terrible. Absolutely horrible.
Perfectly. He says, when you grow up, you start doubting what people say. Absolutely. It's called the age of reason. When you get to a certain age and or, it's not always about age, it's about maturity level. When you reach a certain maturity level in life, you realize that not everything that's said on the internet is truth, okay? You realize that not everything that's, posted or propagated as some kind of slander or drama, anything. The bottom line is the more ludicrous something's...
Wait a second, Phil. The problem is that everything that's said about you can be backed up, can be proven, whether through receipts, through video, through your own words. Anything and everything that people say about you, for the most part, can be backed up. Without a doubt. Your own actions. You betray yourself more than anything. So, yeah, let's just keep that in mind.
Downs, chances are it is ludicrous.
By the way, I really desperately need the money to help with my tax situation.
Sure do.
So, hint, hint. Save the house. I really need the money to keep this house.
Mm-hmm.
I need to raise a lot of money this month. I'm going to need your guys' help. I really am. I'm going to need your support. I need it. I need that money. I really do. I need that money to pay my bills.
You sure do?
It may be based on a snippet of truth in a lot of cases, but most times, if it's ludicrous, it's probably ludicrous for the sake of being ludicrous to cause drama, and it's not true, okay? I'm not always saying that's the case, but that's pretty much...
He did it again! It's just like that snippet of truth thing. See, that's what I'm saying, Phil. You will shoot yourself. He'll shoot himself twice before he gets a shot off once. You don't have to make logic of it. Just, it's like anything else with Phil. Give him time. He'll betray himself. He can't help it. He just can't help it. He'll always betray himself. Just give him time.
I promise you, he'll just give him time. If you're patient enough, he'll screw himself over.
The tenet that I live by, the more absolutely off-the-wall ridiculous something sounds, chances are it's probably not 100% true. Maybe a part of it is, but probably it was blown out of...
Yet again. Yet again. You know what I'm saying? He will screw himself over. Just give him time. Why, Phil? Why?
Proportioned by a bunch of people who just wanted to cause a dramatic scene, okay?
I got completely exposed.
Once we hit the goal of 500 subs, which it looks like we may do within a couple days here, where every day I'm gaining more and more subs, so another couple days we may, boom, hit it. That's the tier 2 goal, which means...
Yes, you can believe it, folks. What people actually wanted for the reward for this goal was like another DSP tries it in the shower. That's what people want, I mean...
If we exceed that goal, I'll do another tier goal for subs, but for see if we can reach it to the end of the month. And I got another really good idea. Better.
Now, this is something that Almighty Tevin, shout out to Almighty Tevin, had said in a video a long time ago. Back when Phil first started Patreon, he had like 3 or 4 tier goals. But keep in mind, it wasn't $1,250 back in those days. It was like, I'm sure some of you guys might remember, but it was like 300, 500, 700, maybe 8, something along those lines. But he used to do tier goals a lot back in the day. And essentially, it looks like that's what he's trying to do now. Yet again, his double and triple dipping. So let's see what his next goal is going to be.
Than even the shower DSP tries idea, I think.
Greed is massively strong. I have no fucking self-control.
Nope. The Radiant Viking did a 30-bit cheer.
This guy fucking sucks my dick. He also likes anals.
And he's talking about, he's actually specifically here referencing what I was talking about earlier with, you know, being careful with what kind of information you put on the internet and what people will do with it, okay? He says, imagine if people called you a pedo publicly when you work with kids for a living. It does kind of suck you in, Phil. It's not that easy to not be pissed off. No, I hear you, dude.
My girlfriend, it's Darth Vader Van Viking with a wig. It was a natural attraction. We're soulmates.
That's what I mean. Like, I'm not above it. I certainly...
Soulmates. That's beautiful. It really is. It really is. It's touching. Just very, very touching.
Myself have gotten sucked into the black hole in my life, and I understand how you can get sucked in. I do. But the problem is with these kind of people, the more you engage them, the worse it gets, right? It's like, what's a good analogy here? Like, for example, if you get stuck in a spider web, right? A big, nasty spider web. If you just stay still, you're stuck, but at least you can still kind of move. The more you get tangled into the fucking spider web, you're going to keep wrapping yourself up and up and up until you're fuck.
Are you... What? All right, let's... The worst analogy ever.
Cocoon, right? That's kind of what it is like dealing with these people, right? If you get affected by them, okay, you got a little bit of shit on you. But the last thing you want to do is run face first into the toilet full of it. You know what I mean? You're never going to get the stank of shit off of you then. That's the problem. That's how these people are. They're so toxic. They will find ways to continue it and keep it going and sucking you in over and over and over. Runky said quicksand, not spiderweb. Okay, maybe that's a better analogy. I don't know, because I've never personally been stuck in quicksand. But you walk into quicksand, if you just stand still, you're fine.
Have you been stuck in a spiderweb before? I mean, I'm just saying, let's go by that logic for a minute. You've never been stuck in quicksand before. That's fine. But have you been stuck in a spiderweb before? I mean, I hear... The spiders out there in Seattle are something to behold, quite fierce. You know, here the webbing is rather serious out there. But have you been stuck in one of those, Phil? You don't go outside, so I doubt that was the case. What was it? Okay, I'm just saying.
The more you move, the deeper you suck. Get sucked, right?
Wow, Phil, you must really want the maid to get there. Either the suction's for the air condition, is for the Either the suction is for the vacuum cleaner or for yourself. I don't even really care which one. I'm just going to throw it out there.
So,
unless you want to get deeply sucked by Darth Vader Van Viking with a wig.
You don't want to get deeply sucked by the wrong people, folks, all right? Stay away from these people who are deep suckers. Let's put it that way. All right.
Don't get sucked into the pool. Don't get sucked by the wrong people. You don't want to get sucked in and sucked off by the wrong people. Burn in hell, Brunel.
Oh, boy.
And I'm going to burn in hell for the rest of eternity.
Probably.
Because of it.
Yeah.
You can't change who you are, I guess.
Sadly, no.
What pasta do you prefer?
All right, ladies and gentlemen. So that was the greatness of Snort Brunel. never fails. So that was great. We're going to go into our GTG music segment. I have a double play for you. And then we will hit Mr. Stuffs after that, which should be good. And then we'll have, I don't even know how many more music selections I have for you after that. Timestamps will be in the video as usual. Hope you guys enjoy. And I'll see you guys in just a minute. Thank you.
one other thing, and by the way, folks, this is very brief. Just got to cover this. I want to cover this publicly.
All right, guys, we're back. Mr. Stuffs, DSP Gaming, statement on doxing. Or statement on the dox. Doxing, sorry.
Talked about it on Twitter last night. I'm going to talk about it again. In particular, to you guys who are regular stream attendees, you guys and gals are very awesome. You guys have a lot of fun with me on a daily basis. You share gameplay experiences with me. We interact on stream, right? You guys, some of you, cheer, sub, and tip, and I'm greatly appreciative for that, okay? But I got to be honest, and I got to talk up front about some stuff for your own safety and protection. I feel that every once in a while, as a PSA, I should probably address these kind of stuff, all right? So let's go ahead and talk about it.
Probably. You should be doing everything you can to keep your community safe, Phil. Like, people look up to you, and they come onto platforms where you are directly responsible for, like your forums, for example. You are, in a way, responsible for their safety. Now, granted, there should be precautions taken on their end, just like you should have taken precautions when you moved over to Seattle, as it pertains to your taxes. That's neither here nor there. Fuck that. That was your responsibility. You should have taken care of that. Same thing with these kids who trust you so much. They are kids, most of them. You should be looking out for their well-being. And that's what your forum is supposed to be. Let's be honest.
FYI, folks, sometimes if you're a fan of mine or a viewer and, you know, you're being positive and supportive in various ways, whether it's just, you know, being a viewer and saying nice stuff in the stream chat and participating with other chatters, or if it's your cheer, sub, or tip, whatever it may be, sometimes you'll notice you get harassed. It happens. It's the fucking internet, right? I mean, there's people out there who just have nothing better to do with their lives than to obsess over people on the internet, and when they see someone supporting someone they don't like, they're gonna attack them, okay? So, as a PSA, here's a few things that I feel that I should let you know. Number one, if you get attacked by someone, don't take it personally and don't take it seriously. What I do is I think about the situation this person must be in their life, that they're so uptight and they're so obsessed, right? That someone who's interacting with me on a stream would actually, you know, be messaged or bothered by someone. It's just ludicrous to me. Just think about it. Would you waste your time? You know, if you, for example, let's say someone you didn't like was doing a live stream right now, and you saw someone in the stream chat being nice to them, would you then personally message that person and insult them? Of course not. Most people with intelligent brains, brains that work, that are hinged properly, right, or screwed in correctly, don't do that kind of shit. We realize how dumb that is, how immature, how puerile, how...
You know, it's funny. Similar scenarios, similar. How that War Dog Leader situation happened. Where, oh, we don't know if that really happened to you, War Dog, so, you know, I have to take that with a grain of salt. You know what I mean? You're derailing the stream chat. So who's to say that anybody who donates to Phil and then come back a few minutes later and be like, hey, Phil, this person right here messaged me and said that I was a dumbass or I was this, that, and the third for donating money to you. Where's the Carfax? Where's the message? Why didn't they just copy and paste it and put it up? I don't recall ever seeing any of that. So what's going on? Just saying, I just thought that I'd point that out, because you were so quick to point that out for somebody else, so I figured you would hold, you know, some of your audience, you know, to that same standard. But I might be talking to the wrong person as it pertains to standards.
You know, drama-esque, that kind of shit, you don't do that. That, you know, if you like the person, you watch their stuff. If you don't like the person, you do what else you're going to do, right? You don't bother with that shit. It's such a waste of time.
You know, like when people bring up PewDiePie and you shit on them, or Markiplier, or anybody who's just more successful than you? You could just avoid the question, but you don't. You just go ahead on this whole bashing situation. I just thought I'd bring that up, because I feel like, you know, that's a situation in itself. I could be wrong, though. I could be wrong.
So that being said, normal people wouldn't do that shit. So I just think, man, that poor person must be so screwed in the head that they would do shit like this, right? I kind of feel bad for him. I honestly do. You gotta kind of approach it like that. Don't approach this man as an annoying troll. You're like, man, this person, they're in a bad way, okay? So that's number one. Don't get all upset about it. It's nothing to be upset about. It's just an idiot. It's just someone who needs help, okay? Number two, FYI, if it happens here on Twitch, if you're warned, okay? If it does happen on Twitch, okay, you can block the person by, I think the command is /ignore, then do a space, and then put their name, and I'm pretty sure you will not get messages from them anymore. In addition, if you click on their name, you can report them to Twitch and have them banned from the site, which you should absolutely do, especially if the stuff they're saying to you is very offensive. And if you see that they're also in the stream chat, just notify a mod, and the mods will look into it and possibly, you know, get them on a stream chat too to make sure that they don't stink up the stream chat as well, okay? Fair enough. All right, so there you go. So there you go, whatsoever, folks. That's number one, okay? Number two, I will say this, folks. If you want to be careful in the modern era, you got to be careful what you put out on the internet about yourself. This includes not only here in Twitch stream chat, okay? This includes on other websites, on social media. You got to be careful because some people say, oh, it's all safe, right? So I'll put all. I'm Joe from Hoboken, New Jersey, and here's a picture of me in my work shirt of where I work. That is terrible, a terrible idea. Terrible, trust me, guys. From someone who has nothing but a public persona for the past 10 years and seeing the shit that people have done to me and knowing that now, more than ever, people can look at your footprint on the internet, okay? Researching shit like that.
The thing is you're going to get a certain level of hate, when you put yourself online either which way. The thing is with Phil is he puts literally everything of his online. He literally brings everybody into his life and whatnot. He has no, safe space, so to speak. He has no personal space. He just lays it all out there and then gets mad when people question him on stuff. But you did it to yourself. No one told you to put all this information out there. People are still telling you to this day. Detractors and fans alike, Phil, stop talking. Phil, keep your pre-streams to the games only. Phil, keep your actually streams game-oriented. Don't answer troll questions. Don't mention other YouTubers or other streamers. Just keep it strictly to the game, and that's it. And he can't do that. You want to know why? Because he knows that he's boring like that. He's dead in the water doing it that way. He has to talk about other people because it's all he has. It's the only thing about him that makes him appealing. Because everybody wants to wait and hear what dumb shit that comes out of his mouth. It's the only thing that he has to bring people to him. And he knows that. Nothing else. Same thing with like that whole, I played the newest games and that's why people... It's for him, anyway. It's dead. It's beating a dead horse. You know what I mean? It really is. Like, for him to base a channel completely off of that and not be able to transition to anything else, and everything that he did transition into, he ended up giving up. He shot himself in the foot. You know what I mean? Yet again, he needs to understand what personal boundaries are, but he doesn't have any. As if anything that he has in his life that can be exploited, whether at his expense or somebody else's, he's going to do it if he can profit from it. And it's as plain and straight as that, to be honest with you. It's vanilla. And it's all you're going to get.
They could find stuff out about you, okay? It's pretty fucked up how much people can actually find out about someone just by looking a few clicks around the internet, okay? Being real with you guys, I know for a fact there's some people that they have shit on the internet and then someone gets pissed at them for whatever reason. Within 25 minutes, they found out all kinds of personal shit about them, and next thing you know, you're getting trolled in real life. And you're like, what the fuck is this? You know, all I did was make a post on Twitter, and now I got assholes coming after me, right? And you obviously don't want that, right? So, just a forewarning that what you put on the internet can easily be accessed, all right? Now, just to warn you guys, to reassure you guys, anything that you guys do in relation to me, meaning, let's say, for example, you're a chatter here on my stream chat, or let's say you registered on my forums and you post over there or whatever. That's all. Don't worry about that. That stuff's good. You never have to worry that, oh man, because I'm doing something with DSP that my personal info can get out or whatever. You know, I don't have any of your info anyway. The only info I ever have on you guys and gals who watch my stuff is your email address, maybe if you registered for my website, right? And that's not a big deal.
Shut that noise up. First off, he can access your IP address. He can find it through his forms. More importantly than that, if you are, as I said earlier on in this video, if you do the, what they call it, like, the community streams, essentially, like when he does subscriber only like events or whatnot, and he runs essentially in a pathetic attempt, he'll do like these little background checks with your PSN account and do all this silly shit. It's almost mandatory, to be honest with you. That's why he doesn't do a lot of them. They're few and far between, and that's why you usually see the same usual suspects up there, you know what I mean, because those are the only people he trusts anyway. He does a lot of stupid shit to try to isolate himself, all because he's scared of being embarrassed. That's what it really comes down to. It's not that he's afraid of being hurt, like physically. It's because he's scared of being embarrassed. That's all it is. It's really sad, to be honest with you, because at his age and for 10 plus years, you should be used to that. You should be able to be an adult and brush that stuff off, but he can't. He really can't. He's the toilet of YouTube. He's the toilet of the internet. And yet he tries so hard to fight against it. The more he does, the more he gets deeper and deeper in it. I'm just sitting back waiting to see who flushes him. Really, that's all I care about now. At this point, it's just a matter of who flushes him. That's all. And if he does, is he going to be a nugget and try to try to float back up afterwards? We'll have to wait and see.
You know, nothing. I have nothing of real importance at all. Some people seem to be under the effect that because they, like, registered for a website that I can have their phone number and shit. You're crazy. No way. You know, that's not how it works. But some people get paranoid, okay? You don't have to worry about that. But what I'm saying is, be careful what you...
False reassurance.
...you put out there. Because you'd be very surprised via Facebook in particular. Oh, my God. Facebook is, like, the number one source for people to get personal info on people. Because they'll look at all your pictures on Facebook. They'll do crazy shit. Okay.
So they do the same thing on Instagram.
Yeah. No, trust it. For me, I don't even use Facebook. I use Instagram. The shit that people have done with the pictures I post on.
So you feel any safer? Jesus, Phil. So you shit it on Facebook, and then you talk about it. Whatever. Just whatever.
Instagram to try to figure shit out. You know what I mean? They could really deep dive into that shit. So be very careful, all right, with what you put out there. Again, this is a PSA. I care about you guys, and I don't want to see anyone get negatively affected by some idiots who are actively searching the internet for, you know, things to use against people, all right?
How about the idiot who started all this, who went over there and antagonized these people to go ahead and, you know, start the harvest? How about that? How about we address that problem instead of just consistently glossing over that and blaming the viewer, blaming the people on your forums for going to other forums? You're blaming everybody else except for what is the actual problem. Which is crazy, because even people in his own community are trying to convey this to Phil. Phil, you have to do something about this. If you don't denounce him, then at least ask for a ceasefire, wave the white flag, do something. And this idiot couldn't even do that right. He couldn't even do that right.
Last but not least, folks, and this is an important one for everyone, all right? Even for me, this is an important one, and I gotta do my best to live up to this one as well, all right? When you see these kind of negative people on the internet who do nothing but waste their time trying to hate on me and obsess about me and do nasty shit about me, the best course of action when you see someone like that is not to engage them and argue with them and attack them or do anything to do with them. It's to avoid them completely and ignore them. Because the bottom line is, folks, if all of us just basically kind of ignored it and just came to the streams daily and had fun interacting with each other and enjoying the gameplay, right? And if that's all that we focused on and that's all we cared about, none of that other shit would ever affect us nor matter. The problem is that people fall into the black hole of drama that is the internet. And listen, I'm not immune to it as well. There's been times when I've fallen, sucked right into the toilet of the negative drama internet, you know, flushed right down into the fucking toxic sewers. And it's bad, man. It's bad. It's bad that that happens. And, you know, it's bad that, sadly, some people, you know, get negatively affected by it.
That's all you have to say? You can't even make a pledge to these people to say that you're not going to do it again? You're not going to try at least something? It sounds like you're really warning them, and you're trying to use yourself as an example, but don't hold me to that example. It's like touch, but don't taste. You know what I mean? Like, what the hell? Or no, how's it go again? It's look, but don't touch. Touch, but don't taste. Taste, but don't swallow. You know what I'm saying? Like, how do you juggle that? You're telling a group of kids to do this while you yourself participate in that very practice. And you will continue to do so. So then you give mixed signals to them. So now you're going to have some of these people who are just going to be like, well, Phil said not to engage. That's why people... At least myself, anyway. I'll say myself in particular. After looking through his forum for a little while, I was always wondering if there was going to be like a civil war that was going to break out there. I know that seems overly dramatic, but let me explain. He has, at least to my general understanding, he has three groups of people on there. He has one group who just wants to support Phil, and that's it. They don't want none of the drama. They don't want none of the bullshit. They don't care about any of that. They just want to support Phil and see Phil be taken care of. Interesting point of view, to say the least. You have the other group that wants to retaliate. They want to go after anybody and everybody who talks about Phil. They don't even give a shit about Phil. They just want to shit on everybody who... They just want to shit on people who shit on Phil. Which is... They're actually pretty entertaining. And then you have the group that's like... Dude, he's supposed to be just playing games. Like, why are you guys trying to take care of him? You're not his mother. And wow, thanks, Kevin. You guys aren't his mother or father. Why are you guys trying to take care of him and baby him? And why are you guys trying to go to war for him? He's a fucking let's player. Tell him to play the game and fix his own problems. I've been waiting for a skirmish between those three to break out. It hasn't done it yet, or at least not to the point where I thought it was entertaining, but you know, yet again, it's because, but then again, the way what he just said there and his actions that followed that is what proceeded to that right there. That's the reason why they're not a cohesive unit. And that's why there's three different factions running around there. But that's neither here nor there.
All right. I talked about this on Twitter last night, but I'll reiterate it. If you go to some website where people are known for being nasty about me constantly, and you register on that website, your info is not safe. Whatever login, whatever password, whatever you use to log into that website, they'll use against you, okay? They will look at your IP address. Yes, any website that uses a forum where you log in, they have your IP address. Now, can they do anything with that in particular? Not really. They could probably generally get the area of the country you live in. A lot of the times, it's not even accurate. Like, I've personally searched my own IP address, and it's wrong. It'll tell me that I'm, like, somewhere else. So, it's not that big of a deal. It's not specific. It's not like, oh, I have your IP address. Now I know your name, your address, your phone number, your social security number. No, it's nothing like that. But still, you know, giving out your IP address like that isn't a great idea if for someone who's going to use it for malicious purposes. All right?
So, it can't hurt you when you're over here, but it can hurt you over there. If it can hurt you, it can hurt you all around. Period. It's not, you're good there, but you're not good here. Or vice versa. If it can hurt you, it can hurt you all around. Yet again. And you should have been honest with these people and been like, hey, this person fucked up. These guys are coming after us. I'm going to try to settle things up. Instead, we already have one piece of collateral damage. And given how the situation had proceeded over the last, you know, what would be almost 24 hours at this point, obviously not 24 hours. I'd say 20 hours. At this particular point, now it's completely clusterfucked itself into a way where now now any little, you know, bullshit statement you put out, any little twit longer you put out, it's not going to be enough. You know what I mean? They've already, you know, spilled blood. Now you're going to have to bleed yourself, Phil, to get out of this. Either that or you really let Rome fall. You know what I'm saying? You really let you really let your community just fall by the wayside at this point. You're going to have to bleed the next time around. There's not going to be some little half-heart denouncing and then that's it on Twitter. It's not going to work this time around. The next time you want this to stop, which will be soon and whatnot, you're going to have to bleed a little bit. It's the only way. Don't try to be lazy about it, because if not, you're only going to hurt yourself. Just saying, you should have been a man. You should have been a man about it and did what was asked of you. And then this could have been done. One man is not worth your community. I'm sorry. Not even you. You are not bigger than your own community. Just my opinion.
So you gotta be careful. You know, where you go and what you register for, you really do. It's not like it used to be. Things on the internet have gotten pretty damn nasty with toxic people. Alright? So, you know, you just gotta be careful. And, you know, I'm gonna be honest with you guys. I've been sucked into it as well. Okay? And I know people who've gotten sucked into it. I'm not gonna be here and stand on a soapbox and say, how dare you? You should be more mature. Because the bottom line is, it's easy to get sucked in. It is. But you gotta, trust me, from someone who's now been through this for 10 straight years, there's no positive thing that could possibly come out of wasting your time with it. There's nothing. It's a complete waste of time. You will never convince a single person on the internet who dislikes me to not dislike me. It will never happen. You're just blowing smoke up your own ass if you believe that. Let these people do what they want to do and obsess however they want to obsess, and let them do it in their own places. And, you know, come to the safe places to come hang out with us and have fun, all right? So, you know, come to the stream chat. Enjoy. You know, have fun, you know, here talking with us.
There's nowhere around you that's safe, Phil. No matter what. Anything that you touch will end up turning into shit. Will end up falling apart. It's just how you're built. No one's ever gonna be safe around you. Anybody and everybody is merely to be exploited and cast aside. That's all you know. That's all you're good for. That's all you'll ever be good for. And I know that sounds extremely harsh, and it is, but it's true. You'll never value anybody in your life that can't do something for you. And after they've given you their blood, sweat, and tears, you'll cast them aside like trash. It's all you've ever done, and it's all you'll ever do. Until you yourself is cast aside. And even then, you'll still continue to practice. You'll just become more and more paranoid. It's all you are. It's all you'll ever be.
And, you know, that's good stuff. Don't go to these negative places. Don't engage these people on Twitter or Facebook or other social media. It ain't worth it. As much, you know, people call it white knighting, all right? I'm going to stick up for this person who otherwise it seems like they can't really have any defense for themselves because they're a public persona, and I'm going to stick up for them. And listen, I understand that you guys are maybe big fans of mine and loyal fans and viewers, and you like what I do. You stick up for me. You feel I'm a good person, and you want to stick up for me. You want to stick up for me. The best way you could do it, be here on stream every day, watch, enjoy, engage with me, and have fun. That's how you can do it. Going outside of this safer space to the places where these people lurk, the disgusting, toxic, you know, sewers of the internet, is not a good idea. Okay? It's not. All it's going to do is, in the long run, is cause more drama and hurt you in the long run. Okay? Trust me on this.
Wait a second. Then why is it that you said in a particular message, I can't remember if it was on Twitter or on your forums, that, hey guys, I can't afford this personal drama, this drama in my life or my business, or to affect the community at large. Please stop. I thought you said it was only going to affect them, though. But now you're saying it can affect you, your business, and everything else. You know, everything else that has value to you, I should say. All right, I'm just saying. Question, Phil. The person that did end up getting the first one that was harvested, the first soul, I should say, how much money did that person donate to you? How much time did they give you by going to your streams? How many videos did they watch? How many ads did they click on? How much time and effort did they put in for you? Does that mean anything to you? At all? Or were they merely lambs to the slaughter? I just thought I'd ask.
I know.
Take a sip. Sleazy asshole.
All that being said.
Shouts out to Tevin. Shouts out to Almighty Tevin. I never thought I'd actually get a chance to say that. Or at least say it in context, I should say.
Hey, everyone. I apologize that I had to take a little segment here on today's pre-stream to talk about this stuff. But, you know, I certainly feel that it's for everyone's best. You know, I want to keep everyone safe and having fun. I don't want to hear, oh my God, I'm a fan of DSP, and I went to this detractor website, and I tried to stick up for him, and now they're harassing me constantly every single day nonstop. You know, that's horrible. I don't want to hear that, you know? And certainly there's nothing I can do to prevent that either.
Hence the reason why he doesn't want to hear it. Ladies and gentlemen, do not let it yet again, this is, you know, broke man Jedi mind tricks. When he said that, I don't want to hear that, he's not trying to say that from a place of sympathy or even empathy. He doesn't have any of those things. He's trying to say is, don't bother me with your bullshit. I don't care. That's what it meant. And don't let anybody try to play it in a position of anything more than that. Because it's not. He said exactly what he meant. He was honest with you probably for the first time on this particular pre-stream, I think this is. So, take that for what you will.
So you just gotta be careful, guys, okay? Super Cat Meow in the stream chat just said, I have to respectfully disagree. I used to be a detractor, but I don't hate you anymore. I feel that you're not what others say you are. Now here's the cool thing. There are people like that, and I'm aware of that. There are people who have come out and said, listen, Phil, you know, I used to actually hate your guts because all I did was follow negative people who said negative shit about you. And then I actually came and checked you out and hung out for a little bit, and now I like your stuff, and, you know, you're a cool guy. You're not what they say. I know. And I appreciate that, but you have to understand that you are the exception to the rule. And I'm pretty certain the reason that people like that come around isn't because someone adamantly kept screaming at them, no, Phil's good, Phil's nice, Phil's good. It was more because you kind of came around by yourself, realized, you know, you were intelligent enough to see through the cultish mentality. You stopped drinking the Kool-Aid, you came over, you saw me play a game, you're like, oh shit, this is actually pretty good. You know what I mean?
And whether that's made up or not, I couldn't tell you. Is that possible? Sure. It's very possible. But then again, before you take that leap to one side or another, you should probably check out his content and see what's there. No one's just telling you to jump over here and just hate Phil. And no one's telling you to jump over there and love Phil. You have to see both sides of the spectrum before you do that. You know what I mean? And, I mean, really, that's it. Like I said, if that's a real person who said that, I mean, if that was the case, if you saw something there that maybe most people didn't see, or at least you saw something there that was a redeeming quality, which is what I would think that was, then so be it. And best luck to you. End of story. There's no punchline.
Tamanese just said it perfectly. He says, when you grow up, you start doubting what people say. Absolutely. It's called the age of reason. When you get to a certain age and or, it's not always about age, it's about maturity level. When you reach a certain maturity level in life, you realize that not everything that's said on the internet is truth, okay?
The funny thing is with that is, if that's the case, then when you bash PewDiePie, why do people take that as the gospel then? When you say that, oh, I really need your money because I got this tax situation, why do people take that as the gospel? When people say that, oh, I'm having all these problems and YouTube screwed me over and Machinima screwed me over and these detractors screwed me over, this, that, and third. Why do people take that as the gospel? Could you answer that? Could you put that in better context? All right.
Realize that not everything that's, you know, posted or propagated as some kind of slander or drama. You know, anything. The bottom line is the more ludicrous something sounds, chances are it is ludicrous. And it may be based on a snippet of truth in a lot of cases.
There we go. That's the word I was looking for earlier, that snippet of truth. The interesting thing about that is you propagate bullshit all day. Against game developers, against games, against pro players, against the community itself, against YouTube, against other YouTubers. Eventually, you'll start cutting away at Twitch. Eventually. He hasn't really done too much of that yet because he's trying to be careful. He's not trying to alienate himself too much. He doesn't want to turn Twitch into YouTube because on Twitch, people really don't give a shit. Like, if you think people on YouTube don't care, trust me, on Twitch, people really don't care. They really don't. And when they can get, and when they get you off, they get you off. I mean, gone. Low tier God's a good example of that. You know what I mean? For all the suspensions that he ended up getting, they finally got him banned. And he's been fighting hard to get back on. And hopefully one day he does get back on there. Because he'll get a lot of growth off that. I think. One can hope. And Phil doesn't want to fuck that up. He doesn't want to screw that up. He doesn't want to fill that up. Going over there to Twitch and really screwing shit up for himself. Because he knows once he's off the reservation, he's off the reservation. It'll be Blip TV all over again. Except for he'll lose way more money. There'll definitely be no coming back. And then he has to sit in the cesspool, as he likes to call it, of YouTube and depend on them. And keep sucking at the worn out, decrepit udder, which is YouTube, for the rest of his days. Which, sadly, might end up coming to fruition anyway. Time will tell.
But most times, if it's ludicrous, it's probably ludicrous for the sake of being ludicrous to cause drama, and it's not true. Okay? I'm not always saying that's the case, but that's pretty much the tenet that I live by. The more absolutely off-the-wall ridiculous something sounds, chances are it's probably not 100% true. Maybe a part of it is, but probably it was blown out of proportion by a bunch of people who just wanted to cause a dramatic scene, okay? So there you go. All right, everyone, so there you go. That's what's going on right now with that. Please be careful. I care about you guys and gals. I do. And I don't want to see anyone get hurt. I don't want to see anyone's information go out. I don't want to see anyone getting negatively affected because...
If that was the case, why did you stop that first situation? You had time. You did have some time to do it. All right. I'm just curious.
You know, because they accidentally, you know, overstepped or went somewhere and thought they were safe. And next thing you know, boom.
Wait a second, so we're blaming, so now we're turning him into he's the problem. The person who ended up being the first one to be harvested, that was his fault that he went to that forum, and that's why he ended up getting gutted. And whatnot. Not the person who really started the situation and threw out all those death threats and did all that silly shit. Okay, I gotcha.
Shit's, you know, attacked and exposed and everything. There's no reason for that. Just be careful with what you do, okay?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go into GTG Radio. It's going to go on for a little while. So I hope you guys enjoy it, and I will see you for our last feature event. Take care. See you guys in a little while. Thank you. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to leave you guys with someone who hasn't been on the channel actually yet, Almighty Tevin, and going back to Phil's threat that he had somebody's name, he had someone's IP, and he had their address, which he got right off his forms, by the way. So that's what we'll use to close this out, and there'll probably be a bonus bit that'll be right after that with Phil doing more of his bragging. But that'll be separate from Tevin's. So I'll see you guys in just a second.
Everyone else out for gaming the system, but don't call yourself out for doing it. At least I can call myself out for doing it.
Now, he's claiming right now it wasn't him. It wasn't me that did this on YouTube, on the King of Hate
Vlogs. And by the way, you can file a copyright claim and say it was anything.
I did submit the copyright claim.
I can file a copyright claim and say Machinima filed it. It won't be legit, but I can do it.
Well, let me show you something. That's the copyright claim for the awesome one.
Are we going to show a
tweet
now? That
is the original post. Notice the name, Stevie Ray. Guess what?
Oh, yeah.
This guy is such a genius.
He used that name again, didn't he?
That he's posted on my website under the same IP multiple times. Deal. In fact, all of these accounts that you see on the right-hand side of your screen right now are the same person. Oh, gee. Does that top account look...
DSP is proven that his mods... His website, whatever, he proven that they track IPs and that they, you know, copy down or remember IPs. Because how else would he know that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 accounts are Be Awesome One if he didn't know the fucking IP? Are you fucking serious, DSP? You might as well say right after this, we have his IP. You might as well say that because this is fucking proof. What else could prove this? His website and his mods already been exposed for all kind of shit. You're really gonna show all of these usernames on the screen and say all of these usernames are the same person? It's the same thing as saying all of these usernames are the same IP. Because how else would you know? Were you in the bathroom watching them? Did you fucking look through the blinds? No. IP. Good job, DSP. Good job. Your website is even more credible now. I really want to join it, and I really want to donate to your fucking Patreon.
A little familiar, Be Awesome One. And yeah, he's also done all these other accounts over the past year. Every single one of which was a troll account, trolling myself and other people on my website. If you need proof he's a sociopath, he created 7 accounts
for
different accounts to troll people on my website.
Now you
may say, but that's not definitive proof. Of course it's not. But how about the fact that his fucking Twitter account is the same exact avatar that he's fucking using for this troll account on my website?
His Twitter account is the same.
By the way, guys, this was DSP Tries It. DSP Tries It. Threats, docs, and calling people sociopaths, drama bullshit. Almighty Tevin, August 20th of 2015. 2015, Phil was engaging in bullshit. This particular type of bullshit that came back and bit his ass a couple years later. My bad, I wanted to make sure you guys got that part.
The avatar he used for one picture, plus on top of that, this Cody, that's Stardust. Plenty of people are Stardust fans. I mean, it's kind of a fucking cop-out, but how do you know it's the same dude? Are you going to tell us how? No. He's not going to tell us.
By the way, I have your IP, I have your name, and I have your address.
Are you...
Yep. Because, like I said, ladies and gentlemen, be patient. Be patient. Phil will expose everything. Just be patient. Time is Phil's worst enemy. Just be patient. Just be patient. Get him, Tevin.
I have your IP. I have your name and I have your address.
Yep.
You say this in a video, bruh?
Yeah, bruh.
Wow. Please, DSP, please do something to Be Awesome One in person so everybody can see your fucking lame. Let me shut up. Wow. You have your IP, you have his name, and you have his address. Wow. You didn't have to Google search him, Doc Sin, did you, DSP? No, you figured it out on your own because your website a piece of shit. Because if you fucking use DSP's website, guess what, guys? You use DSP website and use his chat, yeah, you're asking to be doxxed. Because if you do something like BL someone did, you're gonna have some asshole on camera upload a YouTube video saying that he knows all your information. Wow. This is the lowest he's ever went. I'm sorry. Nothing can get lower than this. Nothing. Race jokes.
Oh, it's heaven. It's a shame that I couldn't talk to you 2 years in the future, because it gets a little bit worse. I'm sorry, Tevin. Oh my God, I'm sorry. It's one of those things, man, where this is kind of like the beautiful thing about, you know, everything kind of being recorded and you having like an actual log of all of everything that DSP does. Because sometimes you can look back at the greats and you wish that you could tell them in 2 years, oh, it gets much worse. You wish you could tell him. Oh my gosh. Let's continue.
Calling out individual people in other ways he's done it, nothing can get lower than this. To say, I have your name, I have you, to basically say I have all your information. To say that about another person on camera is honestly the lowest you can go. It's a fucking threat. It's a threat. It's just that simple. It's a threat. If I go on camera and say, hey, guy I don't like online, I have your name, I have your info, I have your address, and I fucking do a smug-ass smile like that, wouldn't that be a threat? This shouldn't even be allowed on YouTube. This video should be gone. This video should be, this is the definition of cyberbullying. This is the definition of veiled threats. I have your information for real? Wow.
So, congratulations.
Let's say that again.
You fuck. But that's not definitive proof. Of course it's not. But how about the fact that his fucking Twitter account is the same exact avatar that he's fucking using for this troll account on my website? Oh, by the way, I have your IP, I have your name, and I have your address. So, congratulations. You fucked up.
Look at the smile on his face.
You really
did.
He's
smiling.
The awesome one on Twitter. I have all your fucking personal information. Now, I'm going to say this up front. I'm not going to give it out. I'm not going to give it out. This is not a doxing video. I do not condone it. I will never give out someone's personal information or anything like that.
But guess what? Guess what? You saying that you have it and having a smug-ass smile on your face is still a veiled threat, you sleazy motherfucker. It's still a veiled threat. So saying, oh, I don't condone it, that doesn't fix it. Because remember when he got swatted and Fred Fox and the Sons of Kojima and people like me were saying, we don't condone swatting, we don't condone doxing. And DSP mocks us when we say that. And say that, oh, these people say they didn't condone swatting and doxing. Well, you see now, they really want to hurt me. So we can say, well, DSP said he didn't condone swatting or doxing, but he still threatened him. It's the same fucking thing. Why did you say this in this video? Why would you say this and say, yeah, that's cool. Let me upload that. I'm gonna say I got this dude's IP and his address and his name. Yeah, let me upload that. I'm gonna say this in the video and upload it on my partner, managed partner, because if just like he said, if you a managed partner, that means you can pretty much do whatever the fuck you want to do on YouTube, basically. I'm gonna say this on my managed YouTube channel, and I'm gonna upload it. It is perfectly fine, and I'm gonna get away with it because this is DSP. He's gonna get away with it. He shouldn't, but he is. Let me make a video like this, saying the same thing about any DSP fanboy or supporter or whatever the fuck you want to call them. I guarantee you I'm going to end up in a ton of shit. Not even a pile of shit, a ton of shit. A literal ton of shit is going to fall on me. He do it, perfectly fine. Get away with it.
However, understand something. I got you.
I got you.
So, you're in trouble.
Not a threat.
If I hired a lawyer right now, I could sue you.
You don't have money.
Copyright.
You broke.
Defamation. I have evidence of everything.
I see ones and fives in your bankroll right now. Stop all that flexing. You need some exercise. This is Chief Keith talking to you. You fucking broke. My fucking guinea pigs probably have more money than you. Get the fuck out of here, man.
You're lucky.
Lucky.
That I am busy.
You're lucky I'm broke.
Lucky that I don't have unlimited
funds
to go after you.
You're lucky I'm broke.
Because I could if I wanted to.
Yeah, no.
You fucked up.
You broke.
All right? And if
you can't do anything,
all you've accomplished is that you've shown me that going forward, right, with my YouTube career, that I just need to have extra due diligence in everything that I do. That I need to be sure that if I'm going to use something from anyone, that I have to have in writing that I have permission, that it's someone who I kind of personally have a relationship with that I would trust.
At least not talking about this.
Do something like this. All right. Because the bottom line is, even if I have it in writing, a contract to use it, if that person still submitted it for YouTube copyright, it would still go through because it's an.
All right, guys. So. Oh, that might actually be the closest that I ever really get a chance to talking to Almighty Tevin. So that was quite the experience. Quite the experience. Ladies and gentlemen, closing arguments. It's kind of funny how it all came full circle. I really wanted to put that in the beginning of the video, but to be honest with you, it was more fitting to put it towards the end and see him come full circle. So in turn, it worked out, I think. It worked out pretty good. So I very much enjoyed that. As it pertains to the situation, ladies and gentlemen, you reap what you sow, and it's time to, the harvest has, you know, started back up again. Phil had maybe 6 hours of reprieve until he felt the need to open his mouth, and now the blood's going to flow. It is what it is. It's a shame, but all this is for one man's ego, and he can't blame anybody but himself at the end of the day, but let him live with that. Let him live with that. You're talking about, you got people on there who are pleading with you guys to stop, meaning Brightside Viking and DSP, and yet you guys still feel the need to go forward. It is what it is, and that's just how it's going to be, ladies and gentlemen. And that's a shame, but if you're smart, get out of there. Get out of there now and don't ever go back. He does not care for you. He never did. He never was going to. He can't care for anything but himself and whatnot. You have no value. You know what I'm saying? Nothing. Okay? Once he gets every last dollar out of you, he'll dispose of you. The moment that he can't get he can't get any money out of Brightside, into his ass. Same thing with Golden Colt, same with all them dudes. You're gonna have to learn one day, and you're gonna learn the hard way. And it is what it is. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't have anything else to say. This video's been long enough, but I'm glad I was able to keep it under the 3-hour mark. Yeah. Timestamps will be in. Got a lot of music. We were able to close some of this up. There's a David Davison video I want to go over, which talks about Phil and his hatefulness. I'm hoping to go over that. You'll get that later on the week, as I said earlier on. And thank you very much for giving me your time and whatnot. Shouts out to all of you. Okay. Thank you very much for supporting this channel. I don't know where we're at from a growth standpoint, but thank you guys very much for everything. And I hope to keep presenting you guys with stuff. If you guys I've updated at the time that you'll see this video go up. The playlist as it pertains to music and whatnot, and hopefully I'll have the video playlist updated also. I don't know if you guys actually get into those things, but as it pertains to the actual music playlist, so just about everything we've played is in there. If not, it will be. So there you guys go on that. Got a bunch of goodies in there for you and whatnot. Thank you guys very much, ladies and gentlemen. This is DSP News, always late, never breaking, unreliable coverage that you can't count on. A GTG Network and Productions, as well as GTG Radio. Have a good night. This is GTG signing off. End of broadcast.
Yeah. 400 fucking gigs and shit. It's like, come on, man.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know. They came out. Awesome. They came out with a new DLC, Criminals and what, Gaylords or something. The awesome one's tears sustain me. Sending me hate messages now.
He's sending you hate messages. Fine. Are you serious?
Right. Yeah, he's like, oh, stop sucking Phil's dick.
Wow.
Your tears sustain me, awesome one.
Yeah, how you doing, awesome one over in Europe? How you doing? I have your name and address, so, you know, any day that I feel like making a trip across the pond, I'll come see you. It's really smart doing those false copyright claims against me and giving me your IP on my website. It was very smart.